Hello, Rudik Wallace Empire. Earlier, I did a video with Deep Pachare, who is someone who identifies as homosexual and he is open. But here we have someone who is still in the closet and has a lot of stories to share. He was much more comfortable to keep the identity safe, of course, because he is closeted. So we will just do the video this way. So what do you identify as?
I'm still in the closet, as you said, and I think it'll take me another few months to come out of the closet.
So what do you do?
I'm doing my engineering and I'm in my fourth year, so I hope to complete my undergrads next year.
So when the typical question you ask to anyone in the community, like, so when did you know?
to be really, really honest, it might sound weird to you, but I knew somewhere I was gay since I was in the third grade.
Okay.
Well,
it's not weird. I don't think that's weird. Well,
you're generous for that. But I think that, you know, in my third standard, I actually made out with a guy first time.
Okay, that is like, what? You made out with anyone in the third grade? That is like...
Well, yeah, but it was probably Bollywood that was happening in my mind. And I made out with a guy thinking that I'm... Well, don't judge. But I made out with a guy thinking that I was Imran Hashmi because he was the only Bollywood actor that time to have so many kisses on screen. Because in third grade you don't know what gay is, you just know, you know. When I was in my seventh grade, I started to know. That's what I used to think, that, you know, something's wrong with me, and you know why these people keep talking about girls and I'm not interested in them. So until my 10th grade, I really forced myself to be a straight person, and those were the hardest years of my life, to be honest. I just think that right now in my life, I'm at a really good place. I have amazing friends, I have an amazing boyfriend as well.
Okay.
And so, yeah, just accept who you are and, you know, life will be sorted.
Is your boyfriend closeted as well?
No, definitely not. He's in fashion and he's pretty much the greatest guy one can imagine.
Okay, but don't you have a fear that people would get to know if you hang out with him too often or something like that?
Well, when we started, about 15 or 20 days, I was really scared that, you know, if I put snaps, if I put Instagram stories,
exactly.
I would actually, you know, people might start questioning me. But then after that, when I realized that, you know what, this is what is making me happier than I ever was. So friends, family, people around me who will judge me, but this is who I am, this is who I'm gonna be.
Okay, so you say you haven't officially come out to them.
Yeah.
Who in your family or your friend circle sort of, you know, they have an idea or they sort of know?
Well, probably the friends that I've been to school with, my school friends, probably have some idea.
Okay.
And my mom has an idea, and my cousins know, I would say that. Unofficially, but they know.
Not directly gone out and said it point blank, but you know, they kind of...
Probably they're waiting for me to come out of the closet.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, have you ever felt like maybe someone from your family or your friend group does not accept you?
I'm from a Marwari family. So if I'm a
homosexual... High five on that.
Well, yeah.
I'm from a Marwari family too.
To be honest, please don't judge, but none of my family members are like that.
That is great. That is like really good.
So even if I come out someday, I know they're gonna be just amazing parents, amazing cousins, amazing brothers and sisters.
I think you come from a good privileged area where you're like, you're not that scared of coming out because you know you will be accepted. But again, in India especially, there are a lot of people in the community who feel they will not be, who know that their parents or their friends will not. So what advice would you give in such a situation?
Well, if I start answering that question, it will take me a really while, because I have friends who are so scared of, you know, coming out because their families are like that. I have my best friend, I can't say his name, of course. He is a Marwari and he has a typical family, and there's another friend. They just know that there is no way in this world that they will accept us. They will throw us out because for them, their reputation, their religion, it's so important that, you know, they would even consider leaving their child for that. So they have made their peace with it. They just know that they are not going to accept it. So, you know, what they have done is that they have started earning, they have started living their independent life, and someday, of course, they will have that much courage to tell their family that, you know what, I am a homosexual. But at that time in their life, they will be independent enough to, you know, even if some shit happens, happens, they have something to hold on to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That they won't be. So this, I think this is a very smart thing that, you know, even though you lose those great teenage years where you are out and about, out of the closet, but at the same time, it gives you like a safety that, you know, you make your life such that you can earn good enough, well enough at a fine age, and, you know, you can move out if issues arise in the family.
I would just say, before coming out to your parents, just have 2 years, just take time to prepare them for that. For example, it took me 8 years for me to prepare my mother the way she is now. I can openly talk to her about sex, about my girlfriends apparently. So it took 8 years for me to, you know, make my mom who is she now. So please take time, don't underestimate your parents because they only want good for you.
The other thing for a lot of closeted Indians, or even non-Indians for that matter, is that they don't know where to find people just to basically interact with, just to be friends with, if they are, you know, homosexual or bisexual or whatever for that matter. So where did you start? Like, how did you start actually finding people and get so many friends?
To be honest, to find people, when you go to, there are various gay parties gay parties happening around Bombay, around various parts of India. Like,
open parties? Like, do people just know about them, or they're like secret parties?
No, they're open parties. Anyone can come.
Open,
any
legal
single
parties.
Person. Yes, they're legal.
Okay.
Just go to these parties, meet people like you. You will find comforting around them. Yeah.
But could you like share links or something with me so I can put them in description for anyone who wants to like go to these parties or whatever?
Well, I would say there are Facebook pages of, you know, you can just follow LGBT Mumbai, you can follow Salvation Star, which are these parties happen. You can also follow Rage, which is on Facebook. So, you know, you just want to follow these pages on Facebook and you'll get a notification that, you know, there's a party happening. That's so easy.
But then again, these are all 18 plus.
But at the same time, you know, you have to be really cautious about when you start socializing, because I can just share a story. Well, I had two friends so they had a shirtless picture of them.
Are you talking about homosexual closeted friends?
Yes, okay. Closeted friends, and they were pretty much dating each other.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, a shirtless picture of them got leaked on internet, and somehow that could have reached their parents or some friends.
Okay.
So you can't just, you know, socialize so much that you can trust people. You just have to start with the slowest pace possible and be comfortable and trust the guy only after a certain point. Because when you go on certain apps like Grindr, Tinder, there are more apps than that. You can't just, you know, be so open about it. You have to be really cautious.
Trust.
Yeah, you can't trust at all. You have to be cautious. You have to be really smart. You have to play, basically.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anyway, so any last piece of advice or anything that you have to say?
Well, I would just say that, you know, when you think about us, you think about how gross we are, that we are having sex with a same gender. I don't want you to judge us just because of who I'm sleeping with in a room. You know, I am a social activist. I do lots of social work. I help people. I am the same person I am. Just because I have a different sexuality than you have, don't judge me on the basis of that. I'm a person, I'm a human being too. And just give me my basic human rights. I want to marry the person I love.
Alright, thank you so much. It was so, so great having you here. And I so wish that in the future I can release the same video without the whole blurring.
I'm waiting for that.
Anything that was mentioned over here, there'll be links in the description down below if any of you want to go follow that, you know, find more people in the community. Thank you so much for watching. Please do subscribe because I make 2 new videos every single week. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Bye.